Saturday, the 22nd of June, we're at the entrance to the worldwide headquarters of Sweetwater Audio, Video, Professional, Fort Wayne, Indiana, 2013. This is the largest show of its type in the world, and Darren and Dave and Chris are about to visit. It is the 22nd of June, 2013. This is the Sweetwater Gearfest for this year, which I guess is even bigger than last year. And we have with us the man who, with his great staff, is the guy responsible for all this. His name is Chuck Surak. Did I get the name right?
You did get it right.
And he is the president, the chief engineer of this monstrous, wonderful place that we have in Fort Wayne, Indiana. Chuck, when did this start? Give us a little thumbnail sketch of the start, how many years, and things like that.
Sure. Well, thanks for coming today. It's great. I actually started Sweetwater 35 years ago in my Volkswagen bus, and it's been a fun ride, a fun story, and just had a lot of success, a lot of support from customers all around the country. But we started GearFest about 13 or 14 years ago, and it was a very humble thing with one tent and just a few suppliers and a few friends that came. And it's grown today where we'll have probably 7,000 or 8,000 people here. There's hundreds of vendor tents and or hundreds of vendors and probably a dozen different tents or so. And it's just a way for us to give back to our customers and the musicians from the region and actually from all around the country. We've had them all around the country. I just talked to a fellow from Australia, another person from Africa. So around the world, really.
That's the place to be. I've told friends that it's like a mini NAMM, and I'm not so sure of what it is, almost the equivalent of NAMM, particularly for those of us who can't drive to LA or to Nashville regularly.
Yeah, and actually NAMM is really for music dealers and that sort of thing. This is the largest end user show that we're aware of in the United States right now. So it's a great way for customers to come see all the products and technologies, and as you know, they're changing very quickly.
Where did the name Sweetwater come from?
Oh, that's not a very fun story. It's a name that I just pulled out of the air, frankly. I needed a good name for my business, and in the backyard, back when I was operating out of my home 33 years ago or so, I had a small creek, and it just turned it into Sweetwater.
Well, the marketing, the branding, the imaging, the promotion, and so forth, this would be the place to emulate if you were going to start a retail business that particularly had to do with anything but electronics, because you really have this sewed up really well, and I say that as a terrific achievement with all of the competition that's out there, and we see them in the trade magazines regularly, and everybody is fighting over the same dollar, and year after year, and monument after monument, you seem to have made it better than anybody else in the industry, and it's based literally on not always the very best pricing, but the best quality of service, relationships. And you know, the outbound that you do, for example, when we pre-register, we get a personal salesperson. It's almost like a concierge at a hotel. And they do take care of us. We get call-outs every now and then to find out what we may need. And I'm great believers in those kinds of things. It's not unlike receiving a letter today as opposed to just an email. Right. Tell me about your quality of service, your personal outreach.
Well, you've actually done a really good job describing it. But to me, it's pretty simple. Just treat other people the way you would want to be treated. And we are in a world today of maybe a little less customer service than we grew up with, but I think that's the differentiator in what we call the Sweetwater difference. Lots of people sell the same products, and we frankly sell them all for about the same sort of money, but I'm able to take the economy of scale by having so many people here in one location and by having that expertise that we can sell it at a competitive price, but then also offer the additional customer service. And that has been the difference and what's caused our tremendous growth. I'm fortunate that we have 35 years of every year, the top line and the bottom line of our company have been better than the year before.
And that's really tough in today's economy.
It is tough in today's economy, but I also believe concentrating on those basics, just treat the customer right and the business will be there.
Ladies and gentlemen, Chuck Surak, who is the president and just about everything else, along with, I know you would say, a great staff over all these many years.
Phenomenal.
They're
staff.
What makes it happen.
Absolutely.
You're probably the kind of guy that I was used to for a number of years who gave long leashes to people who knew what they were doing, surrounded himself with people to whom he could delegate, because otherwise you kill yourself.
Absolutely.
So thank you so much for joining us today and for spending this time with us.
Thank
it's been
you,
a pleasure.
Thank you, Dave. I appreciate that. Have a great day.
All right, this is Darren. I'm here at the 2013 GearFest for Sweetwater Audio up in Fort Wayne, Indiana, and they've got tents for everything. It's an outdoor event. We got some tents for audio, some tents for acoustic guitar, electric guitar, drums, you name it. They've got one for DJing. So let's go in some of these tents and find out what's new for 2013.
Sweetwater GearFest 2013, Dave Burns here with Evan Hooten, a Behringer. Behringer has done some wonderful things over the years. At one time it was cheap and clean, today it's inexpensive and absolutely great. And they have a new line of digital consoles, the X32. And Evan, if we may walk over here for a few moments, we'd like for you to point out a few of the salient features on this particular mixer, okay?
Absolutely.
We're moving this way, Darren. Darren Warner is our producer today. Would you tell us about this? I understand it has faders that are resettable, presettable, and so forth. And one of the reasons that one of the worship houses that we work with bought this was because they have so many volunteers and the uptime for training is pretty heavy. And with volunteers, nobody ever learns all of it. So they can push a button and preset from service to service to service.
Absolutely. So again, the X32 is a fully digital programmable console. And not only is it fully programmable, but it's fully recallable. So that is everything from the gain settings all the way to your faders. As you see, we have motorized faders as well, so it will remember from scene to scene where you put that. So that also cuts down sound check time in terms of levels and having to re-EQ that. When it comes to, again, cutting down time and all those presets, we have the scenes to snapshot of the full console, but we also can save individual channel parameters. So let's say you have the lead vocalist, but they're not always on that same microphone every time. Instead of taking the time to re-EQ every Sunday service, you can just recall that individual channel and place it on that new microphone position. So you can do that not only for the overall channel, but maybe just the EQ, or just the way it's routed, or maybe just the compressor, or just the name. Again, everything about that channel, you can split it up and either save it as a whole package or just individually.
So the memory that was done here one Sunday can be captured and put here another Sunday.
Absolutely, and I can quickly show you how to do that. You just hit select, we hit utility. I'll save this preset as we go down here. If I hit save, we'll name it something, save it. So that was the red channel. Now I'll come over to this white channel, and then I'll recall it. And as I load that preset and I say yes, you see that that channel fully changed color, changed icon, and even moved a little bit because that level was different. So you can save everything about it. So you can work with a band one Sunday, and once you're comfortable with that mix, you can save each one of those channels individually, and there's your sound check. You can just bounce them around to wherever you will need them, and you're up and going in no time.
Wes Dooley of AEA. Wes, how long have you been coming to this show in Fort Wayne?
I don't know how long, but I've been here at every show they've had.
So that would be the last 13 or 14 years, I imagine.
Well, every show for at least since 6 or 7 years ago.
How do you find it? Obviously pretty good coming all the way from Pasadena.
Oh, I love it here. They got people who care about music, who care about recording. They have excellent programs at Ball State down in Bloomington and Recording Arts. The technical and the sales crew here is so good. You know, this is one of the places in the world where it's a real audio community like Nashville.
And of course, this one is consumer. Nashville is the pro.
Yeah.
I talked to Chuck a little bit earlier, and he said that they have grown every year, and people do keep coming back. And I'll have to say myself, I'm a fan not only of this show, but of Sweetwater because of the way they do things, which is really unlike anybody else.
Yeah, it's amazing. And I figured it out. I've been here every show since they moved to this building.
Wes, thanks a lot.
Okay. Thank you so much.
And with us, we have Megan today. Megan, tell us what you're representing.
Hi, I'm Megan Sampson here. I'm representing AirTurn. AirTurn is a hands-free Bluetooth device that you can use with iPads and other tablets as well. Right here, you can see that the pedals go up and down, and as you hit those pedals, the screen will scroll up or scroll down. We are also introducing the Digit. It's our new product. Virtually what it is, it's a Bluetooth handheld device, just like the pedal itself, but you can use it to do other five other functions. You can use it to take pictures or turn pages as you're doing a presentation, or you can use it for a disability effect if you need to. It's, you can name number is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6, and use to answer questions. We also have our JAMA Pro behind us, but it's being used temporary. It's an application that you can use to turn effects to different applications for your guitar.
If I'm going to run for president in 2016, can I use this as a teleprompter?
Oh, yes, you can. You actually can, and you can use it with this handheld device here in your pocket to turn the pages.
Well, that's good to know. I'm ready to place an order. Thank you so much, Megan.
You're welcome. Have a nice day.
And with us, we have Jay Barth from Starin Marketing, who, among many other fine products with which we've been familiar over the years, is now the rep for SP Microphones. Jay, tell us about the five.
Studio Projects makes a fabulous line of microphones. The CS5 is our flagship, and it is a multi-pattern condenser microphone. It has anything from omni, wide cardioid, cardioid, super cardioid, to figure eight. Has a number of pad settings in 5 dB increments from 5 to 20 dB. It also has high and low pass filters. It goes from flat with a subtle roll off at 15K, 7K, and 5K. We also have a high pass filter at 75, 150, and 300 hertz.
Jay, with all of those features that are available, I can attest to the fact, we're not allowed to mention price on these, that the value factor is significant on this microphone. The form, the fit, the factor, the feel, for me, is absolutely great.
It really is. It's a very, very versatile studio microphone, and the pricing is fabulous. It is made offshore, but it is the quality control is fabulous on these things, and the build quality is superb.
All right, that concludes a great 2013 GearFest up here at Fort Wayne, Indiana at Sweetwater's. Great GearFest this year. The big feature was this drum kit behind me. So I hope if you ever get a chance, come on up to the GearFest at Sweetwater. Thanks.